Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to start a new chapter of class 8 history. That is chapter number 8, Women, Caste and Reform. Students, before starting this chapter, I would like to bring the attention of your mind on the platform first to make you understand the concepts which are there in the chapter. Beta, as you know, this chapter is the chapter of history. Okay, so why you study history, beta? History is not something which most of you think that it is a boring thing. Why should we study what had happened in the past? Beta, before starting this chapter, I want you to come on that platform to think in a way. So that you can understand the things which happened at that time, because beta, in present time also many things are there which are needed to be changed, and who will change those things? Obviously we who are there in the present society, who are there in at present time. The people who brought the change in the past belong to the past time period, but in the present society the change can be bring by us only. So how can we bring a change in the society? Obviously for that it is essential to be aware of the things. The first step to bring a change in the thing, in any of the thing, is to first be aware of that thing. Beta, as you know, our body need a exercise for being a fit. In a similar way, our mind also need a exercise to think the to be able to think that about the any of the matter properly. Our mind need a continuous kind of a exercise for that. And regarding this, it is essential for us to be thoughtful, to be aware of the thing. And after being aware of the thing, we must have an analytical power regarding all those things which are happening in the society around us. Okay, now beta, I'm giving you the example for this. As beta, now in today's society, you see there is an equality which is there in the society. Freedom. These are the basic things which we see in the society. In most of means, these are the things which are there in the society, practiced by most of the people, not with all. There is equality, now a thing which is common in the society, enjoyed by majority of the population. The freedom is enjoyed by majority of the population in the world, in the country. But beta, this thing, equality and freedom, is still there are certain sections of the society which are not treated equally now also, and which do not enjoy the freedom also. There are some poor families where there is no equality between both the genders, boys and the girls. There is no freedom as we people are having the freedom. The girls in our society are having the freedom to get the education, to go to the, now this become a common thing to go to the school. Both boys and girls go to the school to get the education. Now we are most of the people in the society are having the freedom to do any of the to go for any of the profession. There is now less gender discrimination in the society. Women are having a freedom in the society. And there is equality. I am talking in term of the majority students. There are still certain sections in the society, certain groups where these things are not there. But in majority when we talk, all these things are there in the society. But beta, the things were not same which are there today 200 years before. You all have listened the name of the Raja Ram Mohan Roy. He was a great social reformer who was there during the 19th century. Okay, so he brought many reforms in the society. So the result of all those reforms which were brought by these kind of a social reformers like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Swami Dayanand Saraswati ji and many others, regarding them we will study in this chapter. But better the things were not seen in the society before 200 years. Like there were many social evils which were prevalent in the society. Social evils. Social means related to the society, and evils means the kind of a bad things. Samajik buraiyan, which were there in the society before 200 years, which were removed now from the society to a large extent by the efforts of many of the social reformers. And obviously by a legal mean also, by the law also, and at that time the government was that of the Britishers. So the our social reformers, as well as the, it was the efforts of the government of the time who make a law against those kind of a social evils which were common in the society. And in the, that way we were we are now able to a large extent to have a control over all those kind of the evils in the society. So beta, now we will discuss regarding all those social evils one by one. But beta, before telling you about more about this chapter, I want to make your mind to be aware and to keep on doing the analysis of the thing. Beta, studying is not just to mug up the things from the book and write them in the notebook in the exams. The things is, you are here studying the social science subject, the science related to the society. And when you know the science related to the society, then it is essential for you to analyze the things in your mind and to interpret that particular thing in your own way. You can discuss the things with me also. This is a very important thing which is there in social science, a debate. A kind of a discussion and debate is very important thing in social science, in humanities subject. Why? Because beta, this, the discussion and the debate is a thing which make our mind to do the exercise, to be open to our new kind of the ideas. And by that only we can, when we change our mindset, then only we can bring a change in the society. Okay, so whatever I am teaching you in the chapter, but I just don't only grab the things, just look after the thing, analyze the those things and think regarding those by your own set of mind. ये नहीं है कि आप लोग क्लास खत्म होती है उसको बंद कर दे. इन द इवनिंग और वेन एवर यू गेट द टाइम यू कैन एनालाइज द थिंग्स विच आर बींग टॉट टू यू. ओके, नाउ वी स्टार्ट. फर्स्टली वी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द सोशल इवल्स विच वर देयर इन द सोसाइटी. वन ऑफ द सोशल इवल वॉज दैट ऑफ अ पॉलीगैमी. ओके, पॉली मीन्स लिटरल मीनिंग इज मैनी, गैमी मीन्स मैरिजेस. पॉलीगैमी मीन्स अ मैन हैविंग मैनी वाइफ. And beta, this practice was not there in one particular region or like Muslims. It is allowed in the Muslim community for a man to have more than one wife. But at that time, the polygamy was common in both the, among the Hindus also as well as among the Muslims also. And it was because of the reforms which were brought in the society that a act was made which is known as a Hindu Marriage Act, according to which polygamy is made illegal by the law also. Okay, so this was one of the practice, social evil, polygamy. Another was Sati Pratha. What is Sati? Pratha is something which is prevalent in the society, and Sati. Sati is a practice in which when a husband of a wife died, then the wife willingly or unwillingly had to be, she also get tied with the funeral pyre of their husband. Funeral pyre, jo chita hoti uske saath band diya jata tha. Okay, of the husband and get burned with it. Either some women did it willingly, while some were forced to did so. Why it was there? Because it it was a kind of a belief at that time that after the death of a husband, the life of a woman was of no meaning, is irrelevant totally. And another thing was that remarriage, widow remarriage was also not prevalent in the society. Another thing was that widow, it was not allowed for the widow to remarry at that time. and that woman was considered to be unlucky in the society because her husband has gone before her. That's one. So sati pratha was there. But one more thing, like that of the sati, there was another kind of a practice which was known as a johar. In johar also, the wife burned herself willingly, but johar was the practice which was practiced among the Rajputs. Beta, you know, at that time Rajputs were mainly the ruling class. What happened when another king has a control over the kill the one means the wife of the when one king defeated another king and occupied his territory, then the wife of the defeated king, when got the news that her husband got killed in the battle, then she herself burned to save herself from the one who won in the battle. So johar was a kind of a courageous practice. It was a symbol of courage done by the Rajput princess. Okay, so it was different from sati because this was willingly and this was many times unwillingly. Okay, now another one was polygamy, social evil, and second social evil we discussed was the sati pratha. Now third is, at that time the girls were not allowed to get the education. Only boys were having the permission to go to the school and get the education. The girls' education was considered something very bad. Because this thing, if the girl got educated, then she got away from the domestic work. And this thing made made her independent in the society. And when girl go out to reach the school, then when she pass through the passage, then it will have a bad influence on the society. The people who see him, means it, the thing will have a corrupting influence on the society. That was the thinking of the people of that time. That's why girls were not allowed to go to the school and get the education. Another social evil was the child marriage. Both the girls as well as boys were married at the early age, even when they were of the 6 or 7 years of age. Female infanticide. Female means female gender. Infanticide means killing a newborn baby. When a girl is born, then she was killed immediately. That was known as the female infanticide. Why she was killed? The reason was that when the parents were so much poor and they thought that it was not affordable for them to arrange for the dowry of their daughter, then when a daughter born in that poor family, they killed the daughter because of that. Then was the class division. This, what is this class division? Beta, this is the caste system which was very much rigid at that time in the society. The society was divided into four caste system which was there in the society. And the system was so much rigid. Rigid means strict. The society was divided into four castes. At the topmost is the Brahman class, the learned one, then the Kshatriyas, then Vaishyas, and then the Shudras. Both these were considered to be the upper class. Then Vaishyas were mainly the business class. Brahmans, the Pandit one, the learned people, they were the only one who were allowed to read the religious texts. Then the Kshatriyas, the ruling class, the rulers. Then the Vaishyas, they were mainly the middle class, the merchant class, the business class. And then the Shudras. Shudras were the one who served the upper three caste. Apart from that, there is one more, which is not the caste generally, that was considered to be the outcast. They were the now considered as the Shudras, Dalit people. And they were considered to be the polluted one. and were not allowed to touch to any of these, or they were was a kind of a so much discrimination with these people, the Dalit people. They were considered to be the polluted one. They were not allowed to enter the city area. If they enter the city area, they have to beat a drum so that the people become around him become aware that he is coming into the city, and they get apart from that. It was even the thing was so much rigid at the time that if even the shadow of a Dalit person fall on any of the person, then it was considered that that person get polluted even by the shadow of a Dalit person. So this caste system was so much rigid. So this was also one of the social evil. And then the untouchability, same, it is the part of the caste system. Untouchability, who were considered to be untouchable, these Dalit people, outcast people. Then the parda system for the women. It was all prevalent in both Hindus as well as the Muslim. Now also you will see the women have to take a kind of a palla on their face to hide them. So this thing became a hindrance in the freedom of the women. They make women weaker because they were not allowed. They don't get the confidence to move out to do their things. So parda system also kind of a discrimination which was there in the society. And the last one was the patriarch. There was a patriarchal form of the society in the early time. Now also there is a patriarchal form of society, but the extent has come down. What is patriarchal form of the society? Patriarchal form of the society means man, a kind of a society in which a man is considered to be superior to that of the women. Means a society in which the head of the family is the man, not a woman. That is a patriarchal form of the society. So beta, all these were the social evils which were there in our society 200 years ago. And because of the efforts of the social reformers as well as the laws made by the government, there is a control to so much extent on all these social evil. They are still there in the society, but at that time the things were so much severe. But now the effect is very less. Now beta, the question comes in our mind, how and when these social evils came in the society? Beta, when we go to the history, we see that in the ancient history there is a Vedic period. Vedic period, beta, is the time period when there are four Ved, you know, in sixth standard you studied Rig Ved, Sam Ved, Yajur Ved, Ved and Atharva Ved. Four Veds are there. The first Ved is known as the Rig Ved. Okay, this is the oldest Ved, and after that the three more Veds came. So the time period of this Ved, when the Rig Ved came, it was known as the Vedic time period, and the time period of the later three Veds were known as the later Vedic period. So these social evils came in the later Vedic period in the society. During the time of the Rig Vedic period, the things were not there. So beta, when we study the chapter further, we see that all these social reformers like that of the Raja Ram Mohan Roy, what he did to remove these social evils from the society, he took up the verses from the Ved, like that of the Rig Ved, old religious texts, and mentioned that there nowhere in these religious texts, in these Vedas, these social evils, these social practices are mentioned. So why we are practicing all these things? And he make clear to the people that all these are the practices which are added later on during the later Vedic period in the society by the need of the time. And that's why these are not the things which are related to the religion. So we have to rid away all these things. We have to remove all these social evils from the society, because of all these social evil, we are suffering, our society is suffering and can't be able to develop. Okay, so now you understood beta, The society which in which we are there at present was not there in the past. There were many ill practices, many social evils which were there in the society more than 200 years ago. And these, when these social evils came in the society, it came in the society in the later Vedic period. In the early Vedic period, during the time of the Rig Vedic time, these social practices were not there, and these social practices had no mention in any of the religious texts. So all these is about the introduction of the chapter. In the next video, we will discuss about many social reformers and the social reform came in the society. I hope you understood. Thank you all.